This is a study of about 32,000 men who underwent prostate cancer treatment in Ontario between 2002 and 2009. And we examined various complication rates from undergoing surgery or radiation for the treatment of prostate cancer. And we looked at five specific complications that require treatment. The first was hospital admission rates. The second was what we call urologic procedures, or the need for urologic procedures. Third was the need for gastrointestinal procedures. Four was the need for major open operative procedures. And five was the rates of secondary cancers that might develop due to the treatment exposure. What we found was that the rates of complications were quite high for all patients. Up to 30% were reported for some of these complications. A patient's age and their level of coexisting medical illnesses were strong predictors for having these types of complications. What we found that was quite striking, however, was that the specific type of treatment, radiation or surgery, was the strongest predictor for the rates of these complications. This is the first study that comprehensively describes these types of complications. This is a reflection of the whole population and not just sort of experiences from just single centers. And that's what's quite unique about it. We're giving real world experiences. We found that patients who underwent surgery experienced lower rates of needing a hospital admission to treat complications, lower rates of gastrointestinal procedures, and lower rates of requiring open surgical procedures. On the other hand, we found that patients who had radiation experienced lower rates of requiring urologic procedures. And that makes biologic sense when you think about the impact of radiation and surgery to the prostate gland and the surrounding organ. In particular, however, when we looked at the final and fifth outcome, what was striking was that we found rates of second cancer to be higher among patients who underwent radiation compared to patients who underwent surgery. And we compared the rates of cancers to the general population. So we can conclude that these rates of second cancers were attributed to the primary treatment. Another uniqueness of this study was that we collaborated with our colleagues in radiation oncology. And from the beginning, we looked at the various list of complications, and we wanted to make sure that we treated each group, the surgery group and the radiation group, fairly and equally. That is, all the different types of complications were included in each group. We also then blinded ourselves, or we masked ourselves, from what type of treatment the patient had when we assigned the complications that might have occurred during the study period. So I think those two elements gave this a very non-biased look at what happens to these types of patients. So the conclusion of the study should not be that everybody should go rushing off to have surgery, not by any means. What we should conclude from the study is that the complication rates from both radiation and surgery are high, and that we need to be aware of these rates of complications when we have the initial discussion with patients about how best to treat their prostate cancer. Certainly, there's been a lot of strong evidence that we don't need to treat many patients with prostate cancer, and providing this new data certainly will help make the argument that many patients perhaps should not consider undergoing treatment because they don't need it and they don't need to be subjected to these unnecessary complications. On the other hand, it's very intriguing to show that in our study, despite the fact that we did every method to make sure that there was a fair comparison between the patients who had surgery and radiation, patients who had surgery experienced less rates of complications than those who had radiation. And that's certainly very provocative.